The Holy Bible predicts the future before it happens, telling of a time when a beast will rule the earth. The world will worship this beast, while those faithful to the Lord will not. The Bible gives some clues that points to a specific man used by Satan to deceive the world. One of those clues is the number 666. That is the number of the beast.
Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast. For it is the number of a man, and his number is 666.
The book of Ezra, found in the Old Testament, associates this number with Adonikam.
The children of Adonikam, 666.
Using the Hebrew dictionary, we see that the word Adonikam means in English, Lord of Rising. Adonikam is the Lord of Rising, and he has 666 children or descendants. In this verse from the book of Ezra, we see that the Lord of Rising is associated with the number 666. When you think of rising, what does that mean to you? In the New Testament, the first mention of rising is in regards to the sun, in Mark 16, verse 2.
And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they came unto the sepulchre at the rising of the sun. The rising of the sun.
Well, good morning, everybody.
David Garrow, author of Rising Star, about Barack Obama. Let me then ask you about the cover of the book.
Paper after paper, magazine after magazine, TV commentator after TV commentator, all call him a rising star.
Obama made decisions that were not human decisions. He seemed to make decisions based on political calculation going back a long time, including on who he married. And there's a coldness. And I'm not being political in this. I mean, that's really what comes out in your pages, a coldness at the center of the guy that's really striking.
You would think we knew who he was, but he has turned out to be a different person than we would have projected.
To present Barack as a dangerous figure.
The rising of the sun.
In the book of Nehemiah, we seem to have a contradiction in the count of children of Adonikam. Nehemiah records 667. Ezra records 666. One of Adonikam's children appears to exist in the record of Nehemiah, but is missing from the record of Ezra. One of the children of Adonikam exists, and yet does not exist. The book of Revelation says the same of the beast.
The beast that thou sawest was and is not, was, is not, and shall ascend out of the bottomless pit and go into perdition, and they that dwell on the earth shall wonder, whose names were not written in the book of life from the foundation of the world, when they behold the beast that was and is not, and yet is.
I must have had, at this point, 6, 7 biographies written about me, and 6, 7...
The beast that thou sawest was and is not, was, is not.
If Adonikam had 667 children, and one of those children is not, you would remove one from that total and get 666, which is the number of the beast. It is a mystery to say that the beast was and is not and yet is.
Was, is not.
That sounds like a contradiction, too. In Nehemiah 4:21, the word rising in Hebrew sounds like the God of Islam.
Strong's H 5927. Allah. Allah.
Allahu Akbar!
Allah.
So, the Lord of Rising could be the Lord of Allah. Jesus is the Lord and the Son of God. The beast would be his enemy, the Lord of this world, and the Son of Perdition.
Folks haven't been reading the Bible.
In the Holy Bible, what is the first mention of the word rising? The word rising is first found in the book of Leviticus and refers to the rising of a disease, a stroke, a plague spot, a sore, a tumor, or a mark. And the beast wants to infect all mankind with a mark, the mark of the beast, a chip, an RFID tag. Those that worship the beast and take his mark will be damned. It will be a horrible fate for those people. Don't settle for a counterfeit that leads to destruction. Instead, be patient and trust in the Lord, and he will save you. And everybody will see when the Son of Man returns.